Transhumanism is the idea of using technology to enhance our body and our mind for people who want it. So, for instance, we could slow down aging or even reverse it and live in good health for several centuries. We could increase our cognitive abilities and our creativity. We could develop new senses or devices to communicate directly by thought. So the possibilities are really countless.
This is Alexandre Maurer, a postdoctoral researcher of the IC School at EPFL. Alexandre is also spokesperson of the French Transhumanist Association.
The goal is not to say this will happen and we just have to sit back and look. No, the idea of transhumanism is to say that there could be a lot of positive things in such evolution. There could also be risks that must be taken into account. But overall, it is a formidable opportunity to increase what makes life interesting.
Now, one thing that I discovered while talking with Alexandre is that there's actually not one single transhumanism ideology.
There are two main branches of transhumanism, I would say. So the first one is more American and libertarian, and demands mostly the individual freedom to enhance ourselves, which is not always the case today.
So basically, libertarian transhumanism is about authorizing transhumanist technologies.
One of the first transhumanist movement was what was called the extropian, so by opposition to entropy, so it's about a kind of reversing entropy, philosophically speaking, of course, which was mostly Californian and libertarian.
And that's why many people associate transhumanism with the right to transcend humanity, which sounds like it could only benefit a handful of rich technocrats.
But the social wing of transhumanism has been developing a lot during the previous years. So I cannot say for sure, but actually, according to a poll done by the Institute for Ethics in Emerging Technologies, at least half of people that consider themselves as transhumanists, so even more than half actually, are more close to the social branch of transhumanism.
What changed? What led to a more social transhumanism?
Maybe at the beginning, transhumanism was more something that you could say of rich people, so people that can afford it, that have enough money to enhance themselves. But now it's more and more becoming something that interests the middle class, so everyday people, so even people that are not in tech, that can have very diverse jobs. So I think transhumanism is democratizing, and that's why there are more social demands related to transhumanism.
So libertarian transhumanism is about demanding total freedom. What are the demands of social transhumanists?
Things like an equal access to the technologies of transhumanism, public research funding in domains such as life extension, and a form of redistribution of the benefits of automation. So this branch of transhumanism is called techno-progressivism and is represented by organizations such as the Institute for Ethics in Emerging Technologies or the French Transhumanist Association Technoprog.
This movement is thus more about using technology to improve all of society and designing laws that take into account the widespread use of these new technologies. And over the years, it has become a widespread international movement.
So in Swiss, there are movements like Neo-Humanitas, which is not really transhumanist, but interested by this question. In England, you have London Futurists. So the two very big international transhumanist associations are Humanity Plus, which is a kind of federation of all transhumanist associations. So its previous name was the World Transhumanist Association. And also the Institute for Ethics in Emerging Technologies, which is more about this branch I call techno-progressivism.
Use technology to stop aging, erase all mental and physical disabilities, and reach true social and political equality.
According to a study of the University of Oxford, up to 85% of current jobs could disappear in the next decades.